Welcome to the RPA Champions channel. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any amazing automations that we build on this channel. Automations that help you save countless hours of time. And in today's video, we're going to be looking at Flowise AI. Flowise AI is a great tool that is going to allow us to rapidly prototype and build some really complex, if we want to, LLM applications. Now, you don't have to be a coder to use this tool. This is a completely no-code tool, just a drag-and-drop tool that is going to allow us to really leverage generative AI, different models, create different agents, all of this with a drag-and-drop interface. And what is great about this, that this is a company that is backed by Y Combinator. It has plenty of investment, but also what is great about this, that this tool is built on top of a very famous interface that is called LangChain. It's not an interface, it is a library that has different functions that are used by developers to build complex LLM models and applications. Flowise is great because you don't have to know any of the complexities of coding to have to be able to create this kind of complex applications that leverage all kinds of different features. You might be wondering what kind of features are we talking about? So retrieving different kinds of documents, surfing the web, scraping different web pages, using different tools, creating agents, using LangChain, Llama Index, and also 100 other integrations and much more. So all of this is also really easy to set up and install. And in this video tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to install this, how to set up a couple of basic examples and get you going on Flowise AI, building different automations. The easiest way to set up Flowise is to go to their GitHub repo. Inside of their GitHub repo, there's going to be different instructions on how to set it up. So you can choose from all of the different instructions. They're all extremely simple. Now we're just going to go with setting it up with Node.js. So the first thing that you have to do is download Node.js on your computer. Once that is done, you're going to have to run this command right here. I'm going to run this command directly in the terminal and show you what this is going to look like. So this is going to connect to NPM and is going to download all of different libraries that are required to run Flowise, all of its dependencies, and is going to allow us to install it and run it on our local computer. Once this has done downloading all of the different requirements to run this code on our computer, the next thing that we're going to do is just run npx flowise start. Once it has finished installing, we are going to run npx flowise start. Now I already have it installed in my system, so I have stopped the installation process. Now this is going to start the server of Flowise on our machine and is going to make it available from this link right here. So if you type this inside of your computer, or you can just click on it directly on the Flowise GitHub repo, it is going to take you directly to the localhost 3000. And this is your Flowise. Now you're not going to have any chat flows right here. These are all of different chat flows that I have created. Now we're going to see how to create them step by step, all kinds of different chat flows. But let me just walk you through a little bit the platform so that you get familiar with it. Now, all the way at the bottom here are the API keys. We're not going to be looking at this right now. This is important if we are deploying this onto a server and if we're giving access to this via API. What is important though is our credentials. So you're going to need some kind of credentials to use different kinds of generative AI models. In this example, I'm going to be using OpenAI and also Anthropic credentials. Now to set up your OpenAI credentials, all you have to do is create an account on the OpenAI platform. Once you have created an account, you're going to go to API keys and create a new API key. With this API key, you're going to go back to Flowise, add a new credential, go down and search for OpenAI and just copy and paste your credential. Now, I have done this for both OpenAI and also Anthropic. If you go to Anthropic and you create an account, you can get a $5 free API credit. So you're going to go also to here and create an API on Anthropic. Anthropic has some great models as well that are great for coding. I really like them for coding and for some other tasks. Therefore, also Flowise is going to give us the ability to change between different kinds of models very easily inside of our chatbots. It's a really great tool, really flexible and really quick to build automations once you get the hang of it. Now, what is assistance? Assistance is just basically the ability to create different OpenAI assistants, just like we would create them right here on the OpenAI platform. The tools also, these are different snippets of code that we want to have our assistant use, and they're also going to understand when to use different kinds of tools. In later videos, this is a little bit more complex because we require to create different code and then create a different agent or an assistant that is going to use these tools based on different instructions. So if you want to create me, if you want me to create a video that is for that, please let me know down in the comments below. It can be a lot of fun. And finally, in the marketplace, we are going to have the ability to start our chatbot from a template. There are loads of different templates, so I suggest you to explore these templates and maybe start your automations from one of these. Now let's create our first chat flow. So as our first chat flow, we're going to do the simplest thing. We're just going to create a replica of GPT-4, and I'm going to show you how easy it's going to be to switch between different models for this thing that we have created, and also how many different options we are going to have to make it even better and just more customizable than GPT-4, allowing us obviously to create it for different use cases and to save time along the way. We are going to add different components in our Canva. So our Canva is blank right now. We're going to click on the plus icon, and after that we are going to select agents. Inside of the agents, we are going to have the ability to create different agents, but we're not going to be using the agents. We're going to be using something a little bit simpler. We are going to be using different chains. Now in LangChain or in Flowise, everything is about different chains. Chains are the simplest way to chain different things together, like a prompt template, like a model, and so forth, to get a output, a retrieval, and so on. After chains, we have something more complex that is agents, that has the ability to use different tools, use different chains, etc., etc. Agents are just better automations of chains. You can think of it just like that. So let's start then with a chain. We have different kinds of chains, so we said that we are going to be doing something that is similar to ChatGPT. In that case, we're going to be using a conversation chain. So let's drag and drop this conversation chain right here. And we see that once we drag and drop it, we have some fields right here. We have a chat model, memory, chat prompt template, and so on. So if we zoom out, we are going to have the ability also to add some different things. So we see that we need a chat model. It has a red mark. So we would go to the plus button again, go to the chat models right here, and we would search for different chat models that we want to use inside of our conversation chain. So I can add the Anthropic chat. Since I have the API key for it, I can add the OpenAI chat, I can add the Grok chat, and so forth. So let me connect first the OpenAI chat to this. After that, we are going to add my OpenAI key inside of the credentials. And after that, we have the ability to select which model we want to talk with. So we can talk with any of the 3.5 versions and different examples of them, or we can talk with the GPT-4. So in this example, I can choose the best and newest version, which would be GPT-4 Turbo right here. Maybe a vision preview. I think that is even better. So let's try GPT-4. Let's go with Turbo, GPT-4 Turbo. Let's lower the temperature. Doesn't really matter. This is just an example. And let me show you that you also have the ability to add additional parameters like max tokens, top probability or top P, frequency penalty, and so on. All of these have pretty important meanings when we are creating a large language model application. So I advise you to check them out if you are interested really in fine-tuning your responses and getting some really good results. So what else do we need? We need memory. So let's click on the plus button again and go to our list of different components, select memory, and there is different components of memory that we can use. We're just going to use buffer memory, which is going to be using our computer's memory. So I'm going to connect this to the buffer memory. And after that, we are pretty much good to go. So let's name our flow. We're going to call it test one. And let's save it and let's try it out. So hey, and let me just type in hey. So it is working. We are talking with ChatGPT 4 Turbo. Now let's change it. Let's talk with Claude, Anthropic. So let's add a connection credential. Let's add my API key. Let's choose which model we want. So we are going to choose the Sonnet lead balance of ideal for balance, most powerful, fastest. Let's choose the fastest. Let's leave the temperature as it is. Let's just try it out, see if it works. Remember to save this. Let's click on test and let's go with hey. Oh, it's even faster, this model right here. So this is how easy it is to create a replica of ChatGPT. But what if we wanted to make it a little bit better? Well, for example, inside of this conversation chain, we have additional parameters. So this right here is the instructions that we can give to this conversation. So what is the system message? The system message is something that is going to tell our AI model how to behave. So for example, you are going to act as a senior developer specialized in machine learning. And we have given some context to our model. Let's clear our conversation and let's try it again. So let's clear our conversation and try again our model. So let's just say, hey, hello, as a senior machine learning developer, I'm happy to assist you with any questions on tasks related to machine learning. How can I help you today? And with just a couple of seconds, we created a chatbot or a model that can help us assist with coding. Well, not just yet, but it is specialized in that it responds already in a different way. We have the ability to change different models and a ton more of different features. But before we dive into anything else, let me show you something more and even better. So if we wanted to use this thing that we have created right here, we have different ways of using it. If we have a website, we could just embed it inside of our website. If we wanted, we could have it as an API and have it as an endpoint or an API, or which is even better, we can even share this chatbot. Now, once what is even better is that we have the ability to add this and make it as a chatbot. So if we had a server, we could make this a public link and share it and have our chatbot right here. So as a interface. So I wrote again, hey, and it has responded just as I have told it to respond. In addition to this, it is super easy. If I wanted to change, for example, the temperature of this, make it 0.1, meaning that I don't want it to be creative. I want it to respond exactly as maybe I'm going to have a chat prompt template. What is a chat prompt template? So if I go again to the plus item and I go to the prompt templates, let's see if we can find it. So if we go to the prompts, we're going to have different prompts. This is so amazing. It's going to give us the ability to create custom conversations, something similar to ChatGPT assistants or custom GPTs, but better because it has the ability to be more flexible and customizable, much more than a custom GPT. So let's see. We can use a chat prompt template, a prompt template, a few short prompt. Let's use a chat prompt template. So right here we see that we have a system message and a human message, how it should respond. Now all we have to do to use this is connect it to our chat prompt template. But also let me show you that there is other prompt templates that we can use as well, such as, for example, a few short prompt template, which is a methodology for training models via the context window, and also a prompt template. Let me drag and drop this one. So this one is just a simpler version of the chat prompt template. It doesn't have the human message response. So in this example, for example, we see that it is using your helpful assistant that translate input language. Input language would be detected from the chat conversation to output language. And then here we have human text, and inside of the text, this is the message that it would be it would be the training from our human response. In the prompt template, we have what is a good name for a company that makes product, and product is again extracted from the conversation, inserted inside of here, and it would give us a response. Now let me show you a simpler example. and show you also how quickly we can prototype and do different things in LangChain. So let me remove all of this. Just very, very quickly remove all of this and just leave our prompt template right here. So not always LLM applications are chatbots. Sometimes they are a button that triggers different things, or sometimes you just insert some text somewhere and generates you a report, or you upload a document and so on. So if we just wanted to query a LLM, we would go to different LLMs right here. Let's add the OpenAI LLM, and let's also add one more thing. Let's add our chain. Chains are everything, and we should always start with the chain. We're going to add an LLM chain. This OpenAI component, we're going to connect it to the language model. The prompt, we're going to connect it to the prompt. And that is pretty much it. We are going to select OpenAI, and we're going to try this example right here that we have. So you are a, what is a good name for a company that makes product? Once we have created our prompt template, let's try our LLM chain. Now, remember, this is not a conversation. This is just going to be a request that we're going to be making to a LLM model. But once we see it in action, you're going to understand better what this means. So let me type in, for example, car, and it's going to type in velocity motor. But let's do this. What is a good name for a company that makes product? Provide 10 examples. Provide 10 examples. Let's save it and let's try it again. And let's type in car, and it provides 10 examples. And as you can see, the responses here, I cannot ask it, for example, like, do you remember what I asked you? This is not a chat. This is just an interface to test different calls to an LLM chain. So it's going to try to create a 10 company names for this right here that I have inserted creative creative creations and so on. So ladies and gentlemen, the power of LangChain is amazing. There are so many different use cases that we can see. Much better use cases is when we use different documents or different web scrapers, but it gets a little bit more complex, meaning that we just have to add a little bit few more actions. I think this video has been enough to make you understand that if this is something that you like, leave your comments down below, and I will create more videos to show you how to prototype large language model applications and allow you to create agents and tools that are going to allow you to save countless hours of time. So if you haven't done so already, subscribe to my channel. And also, if you're looking to create AI agents or LLM automations for your business, make sure that you reach out to me. I am the owner of Flowise AI. We are a company that creates AI agents. So please feel free to reach out. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.